Yeah. Hey.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah. We've been through a lot. Lord's willing, I'm getting my spot in the kingdom. We winning, no sinning, we not. I'm sending no praise to the men at the top.
Hey.
I just been thanking my God. Yeah. I just been thanking my God. Yeah. I just been thanking my God. Yeah. I just been thanking my God. We've been through a lot. Lord's willing, I'm getting my spot in the kingdom. We winning, no sinning, we not. I'm sending no praise to the men at the top. Hey. Yeah, I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, yeah. I just been thanking my God, ayy.
Why do the heathen rage? Cause we the anointed, and I just been praying like every day. I need to meditate on what is important for me to survive in the daughter race. Why everybody vain? They want us up in that cage. I feel like sinning lame. I'm about to bring a change. Christ coming back, they gon' swim in flames. And I got this heat fall to my chest.
He said the name of Israel would no more be in your remembrance. So what did they do? When they colonized them, they said, let's call this entire group of Israelites Nigerians.
Things in front of us, which we are yet entirely people. Give me John 32. Let's start a thing. Because it is very important. Let's hear what Christ, the man that we said we believe. Most of our people said they believe in. Let's see what he said.
The book of John, chapter 8, and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
So it is the truth that is going to make us free. So one of the truths that we are out here to show you guys is that the Jesus Christ of the Bible is actually a black man according to the Bible, as opposed to what was painted in mainstream Christianity. Jesus Christ not be white man, or they don't lie to us. Understand? That's one of the real things we are here to let our people know. We are going to read out of the Bible, right? Because give me Matthew chapter 24 verse 5. Because people say they believe in Christ, but we have been given false Christ right from slavery and colonization. Since then, we might come Nigeria. You don't come lie to us. But see what the Bible confesses. Yeah. So then, get more details about that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 24, and verse 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
So Christ is giving us a warning here. He said, don't let anybody deceive you. May they not lie to you. Read that again.
The book of Matthew, 24, and verse 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many.
So what I wanted to emphasize is that he said many. So this is not talking about one person or two persons or just small groups like us. He's talking about many on the last scale. This is talking about mainstream Christianity. Your Baptist church, your Redeemed church, your Seventh-day Adventist, your Catholic church. All these churches on the planet, they have lied to us. For us to know, Christ gave us warning and said, many shall come in my name to say, read that part again, sir.
For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many.
So we have all been deceived. For him to say, many is going to come to deceive you, that means somehow, some way, must have left a hint of us not to be deceived. A division of himself, so that we can look at it and say, okay, this one are original, this one are fake. So now we're going to go into the Bible to read the description that he left for us and say, so that we are deceived. Understand? So we're going to read the biblical description of Christ. Jesus Christ is described as a black man according to the Bible.
That's right.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So we are reading from Revelation now. The root word of Revelation means to reveal. So we're about to reveal something that has never been revealed in this Christian church on the planet, right? That's what we're about to read. The revelation of Jesus Christ. We are going to reveal him to you right now. Read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to shew unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
So jump down to verse 11. So we're about to reveal Jesus Christ of the Bible to you, what it looks like. The Bible actually explains it. So brothers and sisters, come nearer. We are going to do a form of match and make here, so we can see which one is the Jesus Christ of the Bible, right? Whether it is white man or it is a black man according to the Bible. So the Bible let us read that, verse 11.
Verse 11, saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, and what thou seest, write in the book.
So because we are going to be able to see, Christ Christ was giving John and others, he said, what you're going to see, you're going to see me. What you're going to see, write it in a book so that in these last days, once we are revealing Christ, we will know that this is the true Christ and this is the lie. Let's see what he wrote down. That's what we're reading here.
Verse 14, his head and his ears were white like wool.
So now John is describing Christ's head, the Jesus Christ of the Bible. He said, the hair and his head white like wool. Somebody get into my bag. There is a dictionary there. Can you give me the dictionary, please? In my black bag. All right. So we are going to get what we read just now. He said, read that again. Revelation chapter 1, verse 14.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, and verse 14. His head and his ears were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So the Bible describes the hair of his hair. So one of the this is one of the reasons why we is this guy's hair white like wool? This guy? Brother, come there. Is this guy's hair white like wool? You can see, right? So this is stringy brown hair. So that's stripe one to this guy. But this guy right here, you can see white like wool. You understand? So I want you to get wool from the Bible, because I want to look at the definition of the word wool in the Bible and in the dictionary, because this is one of the things they messed our minds with about the dictionary. We are the only race on the planet that has hair right like wool. You're half a hair, that's wool hair. When you go to the barber and you cut out your hair, you carry the hair from ground. If you touch him, you'll say it be like wool. Understand? We as a race of people are the only race of people that has woolly hair on the planet. Read the definition of wool in the Bible.
The definition of wool.
Let me say
the soft, cold hair of a sheep.
Let me say
and other animals. Closely cold hair of Negroes.
So we are the so-called people they call Negroes. The Bible, the dictionary describes wool as the hair of the Negro. Our hair. That's not white man's hair. That's not Caucasian hair. That is not European hair. That is not all those wigs that women put on here. No. So one of the reasons why women put on that wig is because they think Jesus Christ is this. Whereas in the Bible, this is a curse when you actually read this yellow hair in the Bible. The Bible says Jesus Christ is white like wool. Should prove that he's a black man as according to the Bible. Let's read up. Revelation chapter 1 verse 14.
The book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14. His head and his ears were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burn in a furnace.
So it described his feet. Sir, I can see your feet. Your feet is the same color as the rest of your body, correct? So he said his feet like unto what?
Like unto fine brass, as if they burn in a furnace.
Brass is brown, derivative brown, that's brass. Meaning it's so dark, it's as if they burn in a furnace, meaning Christ is as dark as charcoal. Let me put it that way. Understand? He's a very dark skin man. He's not a light skin man. Give me Leviticus chapter 11. Let's deal with this guy. Let's go to chapter 13. See what the Christian church have done. The Catholic church, all the churches on the planet, they have this white guy in their church is saying this is Christ. That is a lie. That is a lie. And this is very important. I'll show you why it is important. But read that Leviticus chapter 19, verse 29. This is blasphemy upon the head, and this has gone throughout the minds of our people. Read that. Leviticus chapter 13, verse 29. About hell. See what the Bible says about hell. Because if we knew the truth about this hell, even from the get-go, we would have known that this is not the Christ of the Bible.
Book of Leviticus chapter 13 and verse 29. If a man or a woman have a plague upon the head or the beard, then the priest shall see the plague, and behold, if it be in fact deeper than the skin, and there be in it a yellow thin hair.
Read it again.
Verse 29. If a man or woman have a plague upon the head or the beard.
So it is talking about a hair upon the head or beard. So this, we call it a plague. A plague is a bad thing, right? So let's see this plague. We want to talk about this plague. Read it again.
If a man or woman have a plague upon the head or the beard, then the priest shall see the plague. And behold, if it be in fact deeper than the skin, and there be in it A yellow thing here.
A what?
A yellow thing here.
A what?
A yellow thing here.
So this guy right here, what color is this? Yellow thing here. The French word for yellow is blonde. Blonde hair. This blonde hair, where they carry purple hair. The Bible said that is a plague. Letting you know that the people of the book could not have been people with yellow hair naturally. Right? So this shows that this guy is a lie. So when they even painted Jesus Christ of the Bible as this, that is blasphemy. They are saying Christ as leprosy. That is blasphemy against the God of the Bible.
Example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.
Be strong in the Lord! His word! His word!